Hello everyone, today we are going to start the same chapter, surface area and volume, with a new topic, that is the cone. So here is a figure shown here, is called a cone. Here is a base, is the circle. The base of the cone is a circle. If O is the center of the circle and V is the vertex of the cone, so if VO is perpendicular to the circular base, then the cone is called the right circular cone. If this base and the perpendicular, this VO is called the perpendicular to the circular base, then cone is called the right circular cone. So VO is called the axis of the cone. This is known as axis of the cone. Okay. The length VO of this axis is called the height. We can denote this by H. This axis is known as the height of the cone, that is denoted by H. The radius of this circle, this is the circle. Okay. So the radius of the circle OB, either OB or OA, is known as the radius. And the hole is known as diameter, and the radius is denoted by R. So VA, this is VA and VB, these are known as the slant height. This is known as slant height, and it is denoted by L. VA and VB, both these are known as slant height and denoted by L. So let VOB is a right angle triangle in which angle VOB is equals 90 degree. So this triangle is rotated about VO axis. This triangle, if this triangle, here is the triangle, if we rotate this triangle here around VO, VO axis, the figure so formed is known as the cone. This triangle, if we take this triangle only, so and rotate this triangle B ko hum agar A ke paas le aate hain to rotate ho jayega, and the figure so formed is known as a cone. So here OB is equals R, VO is equals H, VB is equals L. So in triangle VOB, we are having here the Pythagoras theorem, VB square is equals VO square plus OB square. VB is L square, VO square is H square, and OB square is R square. So L is equals to under root H square plus R square. This is the relation between the slant height, height of the cone, and radius of the cone. So this relation, if any one term is missing, by using this formula, we can find that. So this is the relation between the slant height, and radius of the cone. So what is the volume of the cone? So volume of the cone is equals 1 upon 3 area of base, that is pi r square, because base is only a circle. So area is remain same, pi r square, and it is given height. So height is h. So V is equals to 1 upon 3 pi r square h. Now the next term we are having here, curved surface area of a cone. So if we have a circle like this, okay, and this is the center of the circle. If we cut a sector from here, this is the circle, and suppose this is A, this one is B, and the radius is R, and this angle is anything, and this circumference, suppose the length is given here L, the length is given L. So if a sector of radius R and the central angle, suppose this angle is theta, this is theta, is cut. हमने इसको यहाँ से cut किया. So two radii we are get here are joined. These two radii are joined. अगर हम दोनों radii को यहाँ से cut करके join करते हैं, then a conical cap is formed like this. This is the cutting here. This is OAB, OAB, O को और B को हम join कर रहे हैं. तो हमारे पास एक यहाँ पर क्या आ जाता है? Conical cap की shape आ जाती है. Okay, just like in this figure, that is given. and this length is become here the circumference, and this r is here height. So this we got. So let the radius of the conical cap is r. Okay, now radius of the sector, this is the sector, radius of the sector becomes the slant height. Ye side mein aa jayega, this is side, this one is side, kyunki height to yahan aayegi beech mein, like here this is the height, but ye jo side hame milega, corner jo hame milenge, that will be the radius. To length hamari jo radius hai wo kya ban jayegi, slant height. So hamare paas aa jayega l is equals to r. Let the radius of this cap is equals to r. Now r of sector becomes the cone, l is equals to r, right? This is the first equation. Also length of the arc is equals to, that is 2 pi r. ये हमारे पास पूरा पोर्शन होता है 2 pi r, लेकिन ये लेंथ जो है वो उस पूरे सर्कल का एक छोटा सा पार्ट है, तो जो पार्ट है उसे हमने डिनोट किया थीटा अपॉन 360. ओके, सो हेयर इज 2 pi r. सो दिस r into theta upon 360, it becomes here small r, that is the radius. This is the radius of the cone. Second equation. Now CSA of the cone will be equal to the area of the sector. जो sector हमने काटा है वो area, CSA curved surface area of cone, इस sector के area के equal आएगा. तो area of sector is what? Pi r square into theta upon 360 होता है. Pi r square, this you can remember, पाई आर स्क्वायर, पूरा सर्कल, पूरा सर्कल का एरिया, और जो छोटा सा पार्ट है उसका एरिया थीटा अपॉन 360. सो दिस कैन बी रिटेन, ऐसे एक आर को हम अलग निकाल लेते हैं, तो पाई आर थीटा अपॉन 360 इंटू आर, इस आर स्क्वायर को हमने ऐसे डिवाइड करके लिखा है, राइट? यहाँ हमने फिर 2 से मल्टीप्लाई, 2 से डिवाइड, सो 1/2, 2 पाई आर थीटा अपॉन 360. आर को हमने ऊपर बताया है कि आर बिकम्स इक्वल टू एल, सो आर को हमने एल से डिनोट कर दिया. सो दिस इज 1/2, 2 पाई. सेकेंड इक्वेशन हमने लिया है, आर को हमने लिया है आर इंटू थीटा अपॉन 360. सो यहाँ पर जो हमारे पास थीटा अपॉन 360 था उसको हमने बिल्कुल रिप्लेस किया किससे, आर से. आर हमारा एल बन चुका है, कैपिटल आर. सो 2 कैन बी कैंसिल आउट. वी आर हैविंग हियर, दिस इज पाई आर एल. सो सी एस ए कर्व सर्फेस एरिया ऑफ कोन इज इक्वल्स टू पाई आर एल. Now total surface area, that is equals to curved surface area plus area of base. Total surface area हम तब निकालते हैं जब figure पूरी close होती है. अगर हम नीचे से एक lid लगा दें, lid कैसे लगाएंगे, circular. तो circular curved surface area open है, इसलिए हमने find out किया CSA. Total surface area के लिए हमें नीचे एक circle लगाना पड़ेगा, उसका area हो जाता है pi r square. तो pi r l plus pi r square. Pi r can be taken common, so l plus r you will have, this is the total surface area. For the next two exercise, we are going to use these two formulae. V is equals to 1/3 pi r square h and pi r l, pi r into l plus r. R is the radius of the cone, l is the slant height. Here is h is the height of the cone and r is the radius. So we are going to use this formulae. So first we are going to start the exercise 13.3. So first question is direct. It is given here. Diameter of the base of the cone is this much. Slant height is directly given. Pi RL, you can use this. Second question also, slant height is given. Dia is given, so we can find the radius and the total surface area. Direct formula we can use. Now see the third question. In third question, it is given CSA of a cone is 308 and slant height is given 14 centimeter. We have to find the radius of the base and total surface area of the cone. So what is given to us? We are given here CSA of a cone that is equals to 308 centimeter square and slant height is given, that is L is equals to 14 centimeter. We have to find the very first part, we have to find the radius of the base. So directly we can use this here. So first we will write, let the radius of cone is equals r. So pi r l is equals to 308. This is a formula for the CSA. 308. Pi is given 22/7. We can use this. R we have to find. L is given 14 centimeter. Is equals 308. So R is equals 308 into 7 upon 22. This is given and 14. So this can be cut 2. This can be cut 1. 2 ones are 2, 5s are 10, 2 fours are 8. And this can be cut here by 7. So R is equals to 7 centimeter. So required radius that we have is equals 7 centimeter. Okay. Now the second part. In second part, we have to find the total surface area of the cone. Total surface area of the cone. You know that is equals to pi r into r plus l. Ye use kar sakte hain. But now here we can write it as CSA plus area of base. Why are we using this? Because CSA is already given. So no need to find again. Or you can write in here again and again. So CSA directly we can write here 308 that is given to us. Area of base that is pi r square. 308, 22/7, r. Now we don't have r here. So first we have to see the first part because r is given here 7 centimeter. We have found already. So here we can write 7 into 7. So this 7 can be cut. 308 plus 415. 154. So we are having here 2, 6 and 4. This is 462 centimeter square. So this is the required total surface area of the cone. So like this we can do the first part. The third question. Now fourth question is again direct. Conical tent is 10 meter high. Radius is given. Its base is 24. So we can find here the slant height of the tent. Directly we can find it. Second part also. Cost of canvas required to make the tent. Tent open hota hai. So we have to find the CSA. Niche se open hota hai to CSA. Aur jo aayega usko hum 70 se multiply karte hain. Now see the fifth question here. What length of a tarpaulin 3 meter wide will be required to make conical tent of height 8 meter? Base radius 6 meter. Assume that extra length of marginal material that will be required for stitching margins and wastages in cutting is extra approximately 20. The main thing is given pi we have to use in this question 3.14. So we are given here height and the base radius. Both are given. Okay. And what length of tarpaulin 3 meter wide is given here. And we are making conical tent. Hum tent bana rahe hain. To tent ke liye hume hamesha chahiye hota hai CSA. So hamare paas hai base radius. Base radius is 6 cm. Height is given 8 meter. So hume chahiye CSA. CSA ke liye hume chahiye ga L. So first of all we will find here the slant height. Okay. So let the slant height is equals L meter. This is given in meter. Yes, given in meter. So L is equals to under root H square plus R square that we can find here. So L is equals under root H we are given. H we are having 8 square is given 6 square. So L is equals to 64 plus 36. So L is equals to 100 or we are having here 10 meter. So slant height we got. Okay. Now we will find the area CSA. Curved surface area that is pi r l. Pi 3.14 that is given in the question. R is given here 6 centimeter. L we have found 10. So 3.14 and 10 decimal will shifted here. So we are multiplying only with 6. 4, this is 8 and 18. So point after one digit. So this much of meter square, right? This is the area. So area of tarpaulin required to make the tent is equals 188.4 meter square. Okay. Now the length, of the tarpaulin is equals, suppose this is x meter. So this is in rectangular form because length and breadth is given, and length we have to find. So area of this tarpaulin cloth is equals to the CSA. So x into the breadth is given, width is given, that is equals to CSA. X into width is given 3. CSA we have found 188.4. So x is equals to 188.4 upon 3. So x is equals to 36 are, 32s are, 38s are, this much of meter. Now extra length of tarpaulin required for margins is equals 20 centimeter. So that is 20 upon 100 is equals 0.2 meter. So the total length of tarpaulin is equals 62.8 plus 0.2, that is 63 meter. This is the answer for the fifth question. Now the sixth question, we can do the slant height of the base tie of a conical tomb bar this. So we can find here the same CSA, which is given, cost of wide watching is curved surface, and then we will multiply by 210 and divide by 100. Similarly, we can do this part. Now, eighth question. A bus stop is barricaded from the remaining part of the road by using 50 hollow cones made of recycled cardboard. Each cone has a base tie of 40 centimeter, height 1 meter. This is 40 centimeter. If the outer side of each of the cone is to be painted and the cost of painting is rupees this much, what will be the cost of painting of these 50 hollow cones? Pi is given and under root 1.04 is given. So we will use these two things here. So diameter of the base is, it is given 40 centimeter. So first we will convert this into, this is 40 centimeter. So we will divide here. It means we are having 0.4. This is a, now but we have to find the radius. Radius is equal 0.4 by 2. That is 0.2 meter. Height is given 1 meter. Okay. Now, first of all, we have to find the curved surface area. So we are required L. We are required L here. So height. So slant height L is equals under root h square plus r square. So h we are given here 1 square plus 0.2 square. So it becomes under root 1 plus 0.04, that is under root 1.04, and the root of 1.04 it is given here 1.02. So directly we can use it from here, that is equals to 1.02 meter. This is the slant height. Okay. Slant height we got. So first we will find the CSA. CSA. CSA of cone, one cone, is equals pi r l. So pi again is given 3.14. R we are having here 0.2. L we are having 1.02. Okay, so we can remove the decimals here. 314 upon 100 into 2 upon 10 into 102 upon 100, this much of meter square. Now we will find here CSA of 50 cones. So this can be multiplied by 50. So 50 into 314 upon 100, 2 upon 10 into 102 upon 100. So this can be cut. 5 twos are, this 2 can cut. So we are having 314, 102 upon 1000 meter square. Now cost of painting of 1 meter square is equals to rupees 12. So total cost of painting 314 into 102 upon 1000 meter square is equals 314 into 102 upon 1000 into, this is 12. So if we multiply this, we are getting here 384336 upon 1000. So we are getting 384.34, this much of rupees. This is the 8th question. Now we will see the exercise for volume, that is 13.7. Now for the exercise 13.7, we will see in the next video.